Good morning, students. Welcome back to Digital Signal Processing class. In today's class, we are going to continue the concept of bilinear transformation. Before proceeding for today's class, let us take the overview of previous class. In previous class, we talk about bilinear transformation introduction part. Then we have done problem related to impulse invariant response. These particular things we have covered in the previous class. In today's class, we are going to see how to do the problems related to bilinear transformation. In that, first thing, we just want to see the steps. So what is the first steps we need to design to go for digital filter for bilinear transformation would be, first thing, we need to write the pre-wrapping frequency. That is given by omega is equals to 2 by t tan omega by 2. This is the angular omega, right? So we need to find out the frequency by using it. If they gave the value of omega, then we need to substitute in this. We will get the value of pre-wrapping angular frequency. Next criteria is that we need to convert h of s. We need to obtain the h of s. What is s actually? It's a domain which they gave in the question. S domain sequence they will give you. Just want to convert into z domain. So how do we convert it? For doing these things, h of z would be 2 by t 1 minus z power minus 1 divided by 1 plus z power minus 1. This particular factor you need to consider for converting your S plane into Z plane, right? So that relation we need to do it for bilinear transformation. We use this particular factor. Whereas in impulse invariant response, we have seen, we just convert that particular thing into H of Z by taking, what is the formula we took over there? So we took H of Z is equals to as 1 by 1 minus e power minus pk of t z power minus 1. This particular thing we have considered. So this e power pk t of t is nothing but your poles. So we've just took the poles and we just want to convert it, that S plane to Z plane, by using the impulse invariance method for digital filtering. So over here, this particular h of z would be this particular factor you need to use in order to convert the given particular condition into the Z plane. Now let us see one problem. We will take one problem, we'll try to solve that particular problem. We will get the idea of it, how it is going to be used in the digital filtering design. So we will take one problem. Apply bilinear transformation of h of z. So we had one question. So this is a problem. So what we need to do? We need to apply bilinear transformation, same thing. So bilinear transformation. So bilinear transformation for h of s is equals to, same h of s is equals to 2 by s plus 1 into s plus 2. So this is given. So what is given h of s value? It is 2 by s plus 1 into s plus 2 is given. We need to find out the value for it. So it's quite not visible. I'll write once again with another marker. So while, what is the given condition here? So they gave it h of z. So the h of z is this thing. So h of s they gave is 2 by s plus 1 into s plus 2. This is the question, student. So we need to solve by using the bilinear transformation. For doing this thing, what is the thing we required? We required wherever s is there, that should be written over here. We'll not apply partial fraction. Directly you can implement this particular thing. So this is the question with t is equals to 1 second. So with time period t is equals to 1 second, find h of z. So this is asked to find out, finding the h of z when t is equals to 1 second. For doing these things, they gave this condition. So now what is the first thing we need to consider? First thing, we have to write it down. What is the right thing we need to write it down? We have to substitute. Substitute s value. Wherever s is there, what is the value we need to substitute? 2 by t. What is t value? 1 second. 1 minus z power minus 1 by 1 plus z power minus 1. This particular thing we need to consider. So wherever s is there, there are two s here, there we need to substitute this particular factor and we'll try to simplify. So it's quite easy. Only the thing is, wherever s is there, that particular s value we need to modify it by z factor, by this particular bilinear transform factor we need to use it, and we will substitute the value. So we will write over there. So where is this question? Let it be equation 1. This is your equation 1 we had. So now what is the next thing we'll write down? we will substitute this in this particular formula. H of s is equals to, we got it as 2 by, what is s value now? 2 into 1 minus z power minus 1 by 1 plus z power minus 1. This is our factor. Plus, this plus 1 as it is, into second factor. What is the second factor? Wherever s is there, 2 into 1 minus z power minus 1 by 1 plus z power minus 1. Plus, what is the beside number? 2. So, we substitute this value. So, now we will try to simplify this. After simplifying, we will get the actual answer for this particular factor. So we had this value, students. So now what we'll do? We'll try to simplify this. So how do we simplify? So see here. So what we are doing? We had h of z now. H of z is what actually? So 2 by 2 into. I can take it at by 1 here. Here also I can take by 1. I can cross multiply. Here also I can cross multiply. So that particular thing I'm doing. 2 into 1 minus z power minus 1 plus this you multiply it over here. So I can write 1 plus z power minus 1 divided by 1 plus z power minus 1. This is our first factor. Similarly, I can go for the second factor. What is the second factor I do have? Multiply over there 2 into 1 minus z power minus 1 plus 2 into 1 plus z power minus 1 divided by 1 plus z power minus 1. We got the second factor. So what is this thing? We'll 2 multiply with both the things. What we'll get? We'll get h of z is equals to 2 by 2 multiply with first 2 1s are 2. It is 2 into z power minus 1, 2 z power minus 1. Here we do have 1 plus z power minus 1 divided by 1 plus z power minus 1. This is the first factor we do have. Similarly, we can write the second factor. 2 multiply with this 2 minus 2 z power minus 1 plus 2 plus 2 z power minus 1 divided by 1 plus z power minus 1. We have the second factor. So what we can cancel? This term and this term gets cancelled. So we write this particular factor. What is the value we got? This thing we got it as h of z is equals to this 2, this and this. We will reciprocal. We take the reciprocal value of it, division by division, in coming to multiplication in the numerator. 2 into 1 plus z power minus 1 into 1 plus z power minus 1 divided by this one. What left here? 2 plus 1, get it as 3. Then minus 2 plus 1, it is minus 1. So 3 minus z power minus 1 into here 2 plus 2 is 4, right? So I can cancel this thing. This 2 ones are gets cancelled. So we got it as 1 plus z power minus 1 whole square by 2 into 3 minus z power minus 1. So 1 plus a plus b whole square, 1 plus 1 square plus b square plus 2 z power minus 1 divided by 6 minus 2 into z power minus 1. So we got this factor, that is h of z. So this is the way we will solve the question. So in this what we did, we'll try to write down the values for it. For writing this thing, what we did, we wrote the value. So here what we are doing, we took this thing 2 plus 1, we got it as 3 here. Then 2z power minus 1 is 1, it will be minus z power minus 1. Similarly, 2 plus 2, we got it as 4. So 2 ones are 2, 4s are gets cancelled. Upper side, this twice is there, it is whole square. A square plus b square plus 2ab, right? In denominator, we multiply with this particular factor. So in order form, if you want to write, so what you will get? 1 plus 2z power minus 1 plus z power minus 2 divided by 6 minus 2z power minus 1 is your h of z by using bilinear transformation. So by using the bilinear transformation, we got the h of s, that is 2 by s plus 1 and s plus 2 is given, that we convert into h of z by using this particular factor. Let us see one more problem, students. So we will take one more question. So here they give, find the, determine the third order but our digital filter. So we do have next problem. Problem number 2. Determine the third order Butterworth filter. Third order Butterworth filter using impulse invariant technique. So using impulse invariant technique, assume t is equals to 1 second. So they said you to assume this t value is 1 second, and we need to find out the value for this particular third order Butterworth filter. So basically what is given in the question, they gave an order. We don't have to find order here. N is equals to 3, that is a third order. For tell me, what is the third order value? When n is equals to 1, this is the first order. What is our denominator polynomial? S plus 1. For n is equals to 2, what is the second order polynomial by Butterworth filter? S square plus root 2 s plus 1. Similarly, for n is equals to 3, what I can write? S plus 1 into s square plus s plus 1. This is your denominator factor for transfer function. So this thing we are doing, we just want to write down the values for it. So what we did, we got h of s. So h of s we got it as 1 by s plus 1 into s square plus s plus 1, right? So this is given in the question. So thing is, we already found h of s. So first, what is the steps to design impulse invariant response? First thing is that we need to get h of s, then we will take the partial fractions. So what will take partial fractions? A by, what is the first factor? S plus 1. This is a quadratic equation, so we can write bs plus c by s square plus s plus 1. So we got these two factors, right? So this is the first and second. We try to simplify and we will find out the value for it by taking impulse invariant response. So 1 is equals to, what you'll get? Cross multiplied over there, a into s square plus s plus 1 plus bs plus c into s plus 1. First thing, put s is equals to case 1. What you'll get? Put s is equals to minus 1. Here is 1, a into minus 1 square minus 1 plus 1 I'll get here. B into whole thing will be 0. Bs plus c, s is what? Minus 1, this is minus 1 plus 1, this will become 0, we will not take it, we will get A. So what is get, we will get A, this cancel, A is equals to 1. Next thing, comparing coefficients. So comparing, this thing already you know, you already learned in the previous classes. Comparing coefficient of x square you do, comparing coefficient of s you do, you will get the two values. So what is the comparing coefficient of s square? Do we add s square here? No, 0. What is the value of s square? A. What is the value of s square? B. So a plus b is 0. So shift there, that side. So what you'll get? So b is equals to minus a, that is nothing but minus 1. Similarly, comparing coefficient of s. What is the coefficient of s I do have? Here is a is there. Here is 0. Here a. Here. First thing, if I multiply with this, b I'll get. If I multiply c with this s, I'll get a plus b plus c. So a is what? 1. B is minus 1 c. So c has become 0. Right? So what we got? A we got it as 1. So we'll replace this thing with that particular factor, 1 by s plus 1. What is the c value? C is 0. So we got only b. B is what? Minus 1. So minus 1 by s square plus s plus 1. We got these two factors. Right? So now what is the next thing we need to do? We need to write down the value. Wherever s is there, we need to modify this into that particular value. So what I can write? I can write easily. What is s value? It should not be quadratic, right? Still we are getting the quadratic. We need to simplify this thing. What I'll do it? I'll take the factors of this one. If I'll take the factors of s square plus s plus 1 is equals to 0, it's a quadratic equation. Root, if you'll take it, you'll get what you'll get? Minus b plus or minus b square, that is 1 square, minus 4ac, 4 by 2a. So I'll get minus 1 plus or minus, it's minus root 3. I can write as root 3i by 2. So it is minus 1 by 2, 0.5, root 3 by 2. So root 3 by 2, what is the value? 0.866. 0.866 plus or minus j or I. Right? We got this root for this quadratic equation. So this particular equation can be written as 1 by s plus 1 minus 1 by s minus 0.5 plus 0.866j into s minus 0.5. with the second factor is same. So this minus and this minus is plus. So s plus 0.5 minus j of 0.866. Still, if you take the partial fraction of these two factors, what are the factors I do have? Again, we have to simplify this by using partial fractions. So what I'll get? I'll get a value, b value. You try this one. So I'm getting this thing as minus 0.5. First you note it down, then I'll show you the partial fraction of that particular factor. So students, if you take the partial fraction of this particular factor, so we are getting this thing what? I can write a by s plus 0.5 plus 0.66j and the second one. So what I'll write? This I'll write 1 by s plus 1 as it is minus this outside a by the same s plus 0.5 plus 0.866j plus b by second factor. So b by what is second factor? S plus 0.5 minus 0.866j, right? I'll go for again partial fraction of these two factors. So if after simplifying these all, you'll get h of s is equals to first is s by s plus 1 minus. You take cross multiply and find the value, you'll get minus 0.5 plus j of 0.288 by say first factor s plus 0.5 plus 0.866j. Minus this plus into minus, this minus is there, right? For this also, so what I'll write again 0.5 minus j 0.288 by denominator is as it is s plus 0.5 minus j of 0.88, right? 866. We got this factor. So next thing is that after getting this one, we can substitute. What is the impulse invariant response? For impulse invariant response, what is s value we need to modify? Whatever s is there, e power pkt into z power minus 1, right? Actually the factor is this one, 1 by 1 minus e power pkt z power minus 1, right? So this pkt, what is the t is given? 1. So we'll, what is the first pole? This is the first pole. So wherever s is there, we will write e power this particular value. So what we'll write? We got the first factor and we got the second factor. So this, by using impulse invariant response, we need to write down the values for it. So we got this particular factor. Next, we need to write the values for it. For writing this, what we are writing? Wherever exponential factor is there, that we are modifying and we are writing the values for it. So wherever s is there, what we are writing, students? We are writing e power 0.5, because we had the pole as 0.5 in the first and 0.5 in the second. So this value we will write. So e power this particular factor, we will write in terms of first factor and then we will write for the second factor. For both we will write the value. So what we will get? So tell me, what is the first pole? This is the first pole value. This is your second pole, right? So how do we write this thing? 1 by s. What is s value I need to modify? This thing, 1 e power this. What is the value here? Minus pkt. This is nothing but minus 1 z power minus 1. Right, this is modified into this format, right? Similarly, tell me for the second one, minus 0.5 plus j of 0.288 by s plus this. I can write 1 minus e power whole factor. What I'll write? Minus 0.5. If it is plus, it will be minus. If it is plus, it will be minus j z power minus 1, right? For the second pole, what I'll write? Minus 0.5 minus j of 0.288 by, again, 1 minus e power, this is plus is there means minus. Minus is there means plus. 0.866. So this whole answer will be written as 1 minus e power minus 1, substitute the value of e power minus 1, 0.5 plus j 0.288 by, I can split any number power n, like this a power m plus n. I can write as a power m into a power n. Basis can be separated. E power I can write real part and e can imaginary part. So 1 minus e power minus 0.5 into e power minus 0.866j into z power minus 1. Similarly here, minus 0.5 minus 0.288j by this. 1 minus e power minus 0.5 e power j 0.866 z power minus 1. So this is the entire answer of your h of z. You can substitute the value of e power 0.5 e power minus 1. This real parts you can substitute, imaginary can keep as it is. So this is the way we will solve the given problem. What is the given condition? That particular condition value by using the impulse invariant response, for by using the Butterworth filter, by using impulse invariant response for third order, we got this function. So try these kind of questions and keep on practicing. You will get the idea how to solve these questions. So in the next class, we are going to start our unit 3. So this is about complete unit 2. We done with unit 2. Unit 2 is what we discussed in complete unit 2. We started from IIR filtering. In that first topic, we learn about low pass, high pass, band stop. Then we talk about Butterworth approximation, then Chebyshev approximation, problems and order, poles and zeros, and all the concepts for Butterworth and Chebyshev, analog and digital. The digitals are this thing by using impulse invariant response and bilinear transformation that come under the digital part, right? So this particular thing we covered in unit 2. So these are all about your unit 2 by using impulse invariant response and bilinear transformation. Thank you.